Welcome back to our channel. Today we will see some question and answers and concepts from coordination compounds, class 12 in chemistry. What are coordination compounds generally? The coordination compounds are the metal compounds. They are made by the combination of two or more ions or molecules. They are made of metals compounds in which all the ions or molecules, when you put into the solution, they will not dissociate into the constituents. So they are called as complex compounds. For example, if you can take K4FeCN6, K4FeCN6, potassium ferrocyanide. So this, when I put this salt into water, it will dissociate into K plus ion and FeCN6 4 minus ion, but it will not fully dissociate into Fe2 plus and cyanide minus ions. They are called as complex compounds. So as per the definition, they are the metal compounds made by the combination of two or more ions. Here it is ion, this is also ion, sometimes both are molecules, in which all the ions or molecules do not dissociate into its constituents in aqueous solutions. They are called as complex compounds. So mostly these D block and F block elements forms this type of coordination complexes. And they are the compounds. And here, if you can see this coordination compounds, the central metal atom, this is called central metal atom. These are called as ligands. So there is a central metal atom, there is, which are linked to a fixed number of ions. They are called as ligands. Ligands are the one which donates those electron pairs to the central metal atom. And all together we kept in the bracket, this is called coordination cell. That is the coordination cell, or central metal atom and its ion, that is coordination cell. And these are the counter ions, potassium plus, here is the counter ion. So you have a counter ions and complex ions. This can also be called as complex ion, this is the counter ion. Together makes the your coordination compounds. So when you compare to the double salt and this, for example, if you take a double salt like Mohr's salt, that is FeSO4 and ammonium sulfate NH4 twice SO4 ammonium sulfate hexahydrate. So this is the Mohr salt. What is the difference between complex ions, coordination compounds and Mohr salts? When I put this into water, aqueous solution, it completely dissociates into corresponding ion. That means it becomes iron 2 plus, SO4 2 minus ions and NH4 plus ions, such that it fully dissociates into the constituent ions. But here you have one ion counter ion, another is complex ion. This further will not dissociate. That is the difference between both double salts and coordination compounds. In the coordination compounds, the species which donates the electrons are called as ligands, and the metal which receives those electrons and forms the linkages with the ligands are called as central metal atom. Here iron is central metal atom, the cyanides are ligand, and these ligands having the number of ligand atoms present, you see some cases they are called density means, if I take any ligand, for example this is one ligand, so what are the different atoms have the ability to donate the electrons to the central metal atom. So those, that is the number of atoms, species or places in a ligand present such that they can donate electrons to the iron and have forms with the linkages with the central metal atom. They are called as denticity. So the number of ligating atoms present in a ligand is called the denticity of the ligand. So you have unidentate or bidentate, tridentate or polydentate ligands. For example, if I take one example, CH2, NH2 and CH2, NH2, ethylidene diamine. If you can consider, this is having two ligandic atoms. That means it can donate a pair of electrons and forms the linkage with the iron, and this also can donate a pair of electrons and forms with the iron. So they are called ethylidene diamine. It is a bidentate ligand. Bidentate ligand. Because it has two centers through which it can link to the central metal atom. So they are called as denticity, the number of ligandic atoms which can able to donate and makes the bonding with the central metal atom. They are called as denticity and it is bidentate ligand. EDTA, if you can take ethylidene diamine tetraestate, this is hexadentate ligand, or you can say simply polydentate ligand, because here COO groups will come. So that's why it is ethylidene diamine tetraestate ion. Estate ion CH3COO- will come, CH2COO- like this. For example, CH2 ethylidene diamine tetraestate. I have two estate group, that is CH2COO- and CH2COO- CH2COO- CH2COO-. If you can consider like this, CH2, so this is ethylidene diamine tetraestate ion. It is a complex. If you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, these negative charges can act as a ligands. So 4 ligands here and 2 more here, total hexa. So it is hexadentate ligand or polydentate ligand, we can simply say that. So EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraestate ion, it is hexadentate ligand. So like this, denticity can be identified. You have different number of ligandic atoms containing ligands. And then there are another one is called ambidentate ligands. So ligands, they can have bonding with different atoms. Same ligand can have bonding with different atoms. Unidentate ligands containing more than one coordinating atom. So if you take any unidentate ligand, if it is containing more than one coordinating atom, for example NO2 is a ligand. Sometimes it will also link with nitrogen, it can also link with oxygen. So the same unidentate ligand, but at a time it will do only one, either oxygen or nitrogen, but it cannot do both oxygen and nitrogen at the same time. That's why it is not a bidentate ligand, it is a unidentate ligand, but the dent will be changed, that is the linkaging atom will be changed. Sometimes it can link with nitrogen, sometimes it can link with oxygen. So both different types, it becomes two different ligands. When it dent with oxygen, nitrito, this when it dents with nitrogen, it is nitro. So the ligands are different but the same. That means it is having unidentate ligands containing more than one coordinating atom. One coordinating atoms are called as ambidentate ligands, and NO2 is one example for this particular one. And we also need to learn one more thing, that is coordination number. So we have seen the complex ion in a coordination compounds, the complex ion is important. In previous case we have seen FeCn6 4- is the complex ion, that is potassium ferrous ion. This is the central atom, these are the number of ligands. So the number of ligands linkage to the central metal atom, that number is called coordination number. Here the coordination number is 6. So the number of ligands, donor atoms to which the metal is directly bonded, is called the coordination number. If I take EDTA, even one molecule, the coordination number to be 6, because it is having 6 linkages. So it acts as 6 ligands. So that's why generally they will say the number of coordinating atoms through to which the central metal atom has the linkage, they are called as, that number is called as coordination number. So in this case the coordination number is 6, and another one CuNH3 4 times and 2 plus. Here the coordination number is number of ligands, because it acts only unidentate ligand. This is also unidentate, so you have 4 unidentate, so coordination number is 4. Coordination number is 4. So like this we can have two terms. For example, if you take diethyl amine as a ligand, that is C2O4. This is oxalate, C2O4 and thrice and 4 minus, for example. If I take this one, you see this is a bidentate ligand, O, two sides it will act as COO minus and COO minus. This is the ligand. So it is having two dents. So bidentate ligand it is. So bidentate ligands, how many are there? 3. So two, each one is 2 into 3, total 6. So the coordination number is 6. That means iron is having linkages with 6 ligands. Because this is bidentate ligand, it will have 2 linkages with iron, such that total 3 bidentate ligands, total 6, 6 is the coordination number. Like this, we need to count the coordination number, and that sphere is called as coordination sphere. That is what I told, this is coordination sphere. These number, these are the naming nomenclature we should know, such that it is better understand and answer the questions. Okay, so, and there are also called homoleptic and heteroleptic complexes. Homoleptic and heteroleptic. Heteroleptic complexes. So sometimes the complexes are called as homoleptic and heteroleptic complexes. In complexes in which a metal is bound to only one type of donor groups are known as homoleptic. That means, for example, I have cobalt and I have only ammonia of 6 times. Ammonia 6 times, then 3 plus. This is called homoleptic because the central metal atom having linkages with only ammonia. So one type of ligand it is there. So then it is called homoleptic. If I have two different types of ligands to which the central metal atom had the linkages, then they are called heteroleptic. So now in this case, this is a homoleptic. If you want to see the heteroleptic, CONH3 4 times. 4 times, then Cl 2 times, you see, then this is heteroleptic, Cl 2 times plus. So now what will happen, the cobalt is having linkages with two different types of ligands. One is chloride ion is one ligand, another is ammonium is another ligand. So if a central atom is linked with two different types of ligands, they are called heteroleptic complexes. Or if they have only one type of ligand, they are called homoleptic leptic complexes. So these are the things we need to know. So next. And then we will go for the nomenclature. We will directly see the some of the question and answers. From there we can, if some concepts are there still, we can able to explain them. So they ask the first question. IUPAC name of the complex. This is also very very important concepts. IUPAC names are very tricky names. Sometimes we need to understand better way. So IUPAC names of the complex they have given. Complex is platinum, EN 2 times and Cl 2 times, and the ion is positive, 2 plus ion. And they also asked what type of isomer zone it will show. So the, in these complexes we have different types of isomer zone, like ionization isomer zone, solvate hydrate isomer zone, linkage isomer zone, coordination isomer zone, stereo isomer zone, optical isomer zone. In the stereo you will have geometrical and optical isomer zone. So we need to know all these things. First we will see what is the compound name this is. So we need to first see the ligands. Here chloride ion, here ethylidine diamine. EN is ethylidine diamine. Whenever there is a ligand, in the name itself, if you have di, tri something, those ligands, if they have two, you need to use bis. If they are three, you have to use tris. So bis, tris, and tetra, kis. So these are the names we need to use if they have multiple number of ligands. But the ligand name itself, for example, ethylidene diamine. Ethylidene diamine. Diamine. So in the name itself you have di. So that's why if such ligands are two are there, you need to use bis. If such ligands are three are there, tris. Such ligands are four are there, tetrakis, etc. We can use. So that's why the naming to be understood. If the chloride is there, you no need to use bis, you can just write a dichloro. But if I have ethylidene diamine, I need to write bis. Clear? So this naming we need to first understand. So the name what we will write here is, first you mention the ligands as per the alphabetical order. So chloro will come first, so you write chloro. This is ethylidene diamine E, so this is C, so you comes chloro. First you write the chloro name, that is dichloro, 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 two chlorides atoms. Then you have two ethylidene diamine, so the two you have to mention with respect to bis. So bis, so ethane 1,2 diamine or ethylidene diamine. So better you put this and write ethane 1,2 diamine, ethane 1,2 diamine. Ethane 1,2 diamine, that is ethylidene diamine, that name will be ethane 1,2 diamine as per the UPSC. Then done, you have done the ligands naming. So dichlorobis, that is two chlorides, and bis and ethane 1,2 diamine. Now you need to come to the central metal atom, that is platinum. Platinum. Now you write the next continuation, platinum. Then here in these complexes you need to put the oxidation state of this platinum. So in order to find out the oxidation state, there is a way. First you need to find out what is the oxidation state of the platinum. For that one, what we should do, this is a complex ion, it is ion, you will write finally ion, it is ion, they have given name. So now platinum, I need to put its oxidation state in the bracket, then the naming was done. So dichloro, bis, ethane, 1,2 diamine, platinum, what is the oxidation state? To find out the platinum oxidation state, this is the complex, you take it, total oxidation state is 2. We need to find out ethylidene diamine. For example, ethylidene diamine is like this, CH2NH2 and CH2NH2. It is a neutral ion, it don't have charge, sorry, it doesn't have any charge, correct? So this you can just remove it. So X and 0, ethylidene diamine. Plus minus 2, correct? This will not be there. X minus 2 equal to plus 2. So X minus 2 equal to plus 2. So X equal to 4. Because minus 2 goes, that's it, 4. So ethylidene diamond, remember, it is a neutral ligand. So you can just write the Roman number of that 4. So the name now it become dichlorobis ethane 1,2 diamine platinum 4 ion. Dichloro, bis, ethane, 1,2 diamine, platinum, 4 ion. That is the naming of this particular compound. And now we will see the isomerism of this particular compound. What type of isomerism it is having? So this shows geometrical isomerism and optical isomerism. This one showing geometrical and optical isomerism. So the geometrical isomers, you know, that is like cis and transforms. So I have platinum. It is having 6 ligands, so it should have 6 ligands, octahedral similar. So you can have like this 1, 2 and 3, 4, 5, 6 ligands. But in the 6 ligands, 2 ligands are same. That means same species is having 2 ligands. So I can write EN such that it have bonding between these two ligands. And I can also write another EN such that it will have a bonding like this. Then this is one chlorine, this is one chlorine. This is one form of that particular one. So where the EMs are opposite directions, so they are called as transform. This I can write as transform. Geometrical isomerism, the first form is transform. So this is the way we can able to write. If you can remember, if you want, like this we can put. So whenever you are writing platinum, you can put like this. This is the octahedral. So you can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this just to represent I have given, but this is the transform. Now we need to write the cis form. That means both ligands should be one direction. So this is the transform, you understood. Now we will write the cis form. Cis, once again I have like this. 6-1. So now in the cis when you are writing, you need to give two side by side. For example, EN I have given here. 1, okay. Next EN should be here. Then you can have CL here, CL here. So both chlorides are side by side or both EN's are side by side. So that is the cis form. This is the trans form. This is cis form. These two are geometrical isomers. These two are geometrical isomers. One is cis form and another one is trans form. In this case, we can see the next one, optical isomerism. The cis form is optically active but not the trans form. So now we take the cis form and write its mirror images. If I write a mirror image of this, both are superimposable mirror images. So that's why a trans form will not have a optical isomerism. If for example, if you write for trans form, what will happen? Same I will be writing. En is this side and that en will go, that's a top Cl, Cl. So it can be superimposable. So that's why a trans form does not have optical isomerism. So this particular ion of cis form will have optical isomers. So in that you need to write that one. So now platinum, I have 1 Cl. Okay, we will write this first 4 like this. And cis form we have written 1 En, another En and Cl. This is the cis form. So you take the mirror images. Mirror image of this can be written here, platinum 1. This is the way. So what is the mirror image, how it looks? Now this En will come over here, this same En, and this En will be the opposite direction. So I can write En here, and this is Cl, this is Cl. You see, when I take this and keep as it is on this, it will not superimpose exactly. So that's why these two cis forms, these are non-superimposable images. So they possess optical activity. One rotates the plane polarized light towards right, other rotates the plane polarized light towards left. So this is the dextro form, which rotates the plane polarized light towards right, and this is the levo form, rotates towards left. That is called optical activity. So you have seen this platinum compound, dichloro bis ethane 1,2 diamine platinum 4, because ethane diamine is neutral ligand. So this is the way we can have, and it is showing both geometrical isomerism of cis trans. This is the cis form. The cis form shows optical isomerism like dextro and levo forms. Okay, so this is the way the question can be answered. They can ask sometimes only isomerism, or they can ask optical isomer forms of this particular compound. So the IUPAC names of another compound was given, nickel Ni NH3 six times, Ni NH3 six times Cl2. So this is a complex compound fully given, and they asked the IUPAC name of this particular compound. First we need to take this, that amine group, ammonia will be written as amine group. How many are there? 6. So you can write hexa amine. Then you will be writing nickel, hexamine nickel. Then the complex, then you have to give the oxidation number of this. Amine group is neutral, so there is nothing here. So this group, how you will be writing? For example, the same complex, nickel ammonia, you first take the complex ion. What is the complex ion? This is a counter ion, Cl minus, 2 Cl minus. 2 Cl minus is counter ion, that is 2 minus is the counter ion. So it should be 2 plus. So together is 0, clear? So this ammonia complex ion charge is 2 plus, this Cl 2 Cl minus. Now if it is 2 plus, nickel should also be 2 plus because this is 0. So nickel will be 2 plus, so nickel 2. Nickel 2, we need to write nickel 2. Then what is the outside is there? Chloride. So it is like a chloride. You can simply write chloride. So hexiamine, nickel, 2 chloride. So why nickel 2? This is 0, this oxygen is 2 plus because this is 2 minus, so nickel 2. So this is the way we can give the complex ion name. Okay, another one. They asked a linkage isomerism of this particular compound, cobalt NH3 5 times. Cobalt NH3 5 times NO2 2 plus. NO2 2 plus. Ask to write the isomerism. So whenever NO2 is there, NO2 is a ambidentate ligand. It is unidentate, at the same time it is ambident. Ambident means it can have linkage with nitrogen atom or oxygen atom. So it exhibits now linkage isomerism. So that linkage isomerism we need to write. So this is once again hexadentate. So it is cobalt, and you can put all the 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, total 6. 6 are there. So you can write in one case all the anywhere you can write better to learning NH3, 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 NH3. Now here NO2. It has link with nitrogen atom. For example, if you can give like this to better understanding, this is NO2. NO2 is the link. So this is, you have to write like this. So this is square and top and bottom is there. So in this way you can able to put, this is the ion. Now you put together is 2 plus. This is one linkage isomerism of particular one. In the another linkage isomerism, what we will be writing? So here you replace the NO2 to ONO. ONO. That's all. These are the two linkage isomers. Previous one is NO2, now it is ONO. These are the two linkage isomers we have written. So we will try to name that one. So if that ONO is there, what is the name? If NO2 is there, what is the name? So you know it is a pentaamine. Pentaamine, 5 amine groups. Nitro. Nitro. And you see here, pentaamine, pentaamine. Pentaamine. Nitro, nitro group, nitro. So it linked with O, so you write O better. If it is N, nitro N, we can write. This is one way of writing this one. So then you can write cobalt, cobalt, cobalt. Then what is the oxidation number? This is 0. NO2 is minus 1. Minus 1 goes that side, plus 2 plus minus 1. So total is 3. So cobalt 3. Cobalt 3 ion. Clear? So pentaamine, nitro O, cobalt 3 ion. Nitro O, cobalt 3 ion. How to identify when you do experiment? This will be in red color. So this is nitro O group. If I have nitro N group, the color is yellow, and you just replace here N. So the same name is same, that is pentaamine nitro N capital N cobalt 3 ion, and the color of that one is now yellowish color, yellow. So you see, based on the linkage, the complex will have different colors. So ONO color is red color, and nitro O, here nitro N. So these are the two different linkage isomers of this particular compound. Okay, we will stop here, and in the next class we will see some more question and answers from this lesson. Thank you.